Good morning children, welcome back. Today we are continuing the module video discussion. There are five questions I selected which are not normal level. This is sound step ahead, that is application level questions, and that thought provoking questions. You should be familiarized with this type of questions. Okay, 11th question: what is the significance of emulsification of fat? First of all, you must know what is emulsification. Emulsification is the process of breaking down the large globules, which fat globule, large fat globules into smaller fat globules. The emulsification of fat is the process by which the large fat globules are broken down into smaller fat globules in the small intestine. So this process takes place in small intestine, particularly at the entrance U-shaped duodenum of the alimentary canal or the small intestine, where the pancreas secrete, the liver secrete bile juice. The bile salt in it break down the large fat globules into small fat globules. This process of breakdown of large fat globules into small fat globules, and these small fat globules can be readily dissolved in the water, in the fluid. Such a medium is called emulsion, and that process is called emulsification of fat. Got it? Yeah. Now the third question: what causes the movement of food in alimentary canal? Yes. The entire wall of the alimentary canal, right from the mouth till the anus, there is a wave-like rhythmic contraction and relaxation of the muscles of the wall. There is a wave-like contraction and relaxation on the muscles of the wall. What the alimentary canal is called peristalsis or peristaltic movement. And this peristalsis is a very, very important step in which the wall of the alimentary canal, wall of the alimentary canal is made up of smooth muscles. Okay, that smooth muscles, we can say non or unstriated muscles, which are involuntary muscles. This involuntary movement along the wall of the alimentary canal, due to the contraction and relaxation of whatever muscles, the smooth muscles, we call it peristalsis. So if peristalsis does not happen, the food cannot be pushed spontaneously, naturally. You have to put maximum effort we have to put, and it will be very difficult in the normal conditions. Okay, particularly no time in our life, we are very busy working people, for playing we have to be very busy, and all other activities cut short. Okay, so it is very difficult that in the absence of peristalsis, the food cannot be pushed downward or swallowed. 13th question: why does absorption of digested food occur mainly in the small intestine? Of course, you know. First reason: the digestion of food is completed in the small intestine. In small intestine, carbohydrate or starch into completely into glucose, then proteins into amino acids, then lipids or fats into fatty acid and glycerol. So the completion of the digestion of food takes place in small intestine. That is one reason. And the second point you have to remember, that on the wall of the small intestine, inside the small intestine, so inner wall of the small intestine, there are millions of finger-like projections called microvilli. These minute finger-like projections of villi increase the surface area for the absorption of the food. Suppose these are the villi, finger-like projections. Okay, not this much size. The villi are really very minute, and they are called microvilli. And this villi increase the surface area. You can see, so that the food can be easily absorbed by passive diffusion. It does not need energy, much energy. Passive diffusion. Okay, food is absorbed mainly into the blood. And inside this villi, there are rich supply or extensive supply blood vessels. This rich supply blood vessels inside the villi and the thin walls of the villi, helps in the diffusion of the food particles or nutrient particles into the blood. Okay, that's all. Now, 14th question. Why is the blood circulation in human body called a double circulation? Yes, double circulation is due to the two sides of the heart, left and right sides of the heart. You can see that. Okay, during a single cardiac cycle, the oxygenated blood move in one direction and the deoxygenated blood move in another direction, which does not mix. Such a movement of the blood, that is in the right side of the heart, it means that from the right ventricle to the lungs, this type of circulation in which the deoxygenated blood from the right ventricle goes to the lungs through pulmonary artery is called pulmonary circulation. And in the left part of the heart, you can see that oxygenated blood, oxygen-rich blood is pumped from the left ventricle through aorta into various body parts. And it comes back finally to the right atrium. This type of circulation in which the oxygenated and deoxygenated blood flows twice through the heart during a single cardiac cycle is called double circulation. You got it? Now, 15th question, what is the advantage of having a four-chambered heart? Yes, in mammals and birds, there are four-chambered heart. Particularly, this four-chambered heart does not allow to mix the oxygenated blood and deoxygenated blood. Having four-chambered heart, the right side and left side is separated by a septum. That is what is called interauricular ventricular septum, okay, which prevent the complete mixing, okay, of which prevent the mixing of oxygenated blood and deoxygenated blood. Oxygenated blood flows in the left hand direction, left side, and carbon dioxide rich blood flows in the right direction. This separation is important in birds and mammals as more oxygen should be carried by the blood to the cells for releasing maximum amount of oxygen from the maximum amount of energy from the food. So oxidation of food in cells need more oxygen. So having four chambered heart, the oxygenated blood does not mix with the deoxygenated blood, that the efficiency of transport of oxygen is increased to the cells. Inside the cells, the oxygen is used for breaking down of food and release more energy. More energy is required to maintain body temperature in birds and mammals. That is of importance of this. That's all. Thank you very much.